Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta. Welcome back to Darkest Dungeon Season 2. We are ready to go here for our Necromancer Lord kill, the final boss of the Necromancer tier in the estate. And it's going to be, a team that should look very familiar in a way. We have Mathis, the Warbringer, the Deathbringer, the Destroyer of Worlds. We all know who he is. He's going to be rocking this was his head, as well as Legendary Bracer for extra uber leopard damage. Jenna is going to be healing in the second position with the Profane Scroll, along with the Sacred Scroll, because I'm not planning on moving her at all. Davis, we upgraded his all of his moves. Same goes for Frag, as well as their armor. Davis is going to be going for Legendary Bracer, as well as the Ancestor's Musket Ball, which is going to give him a little bit of extra crit damage, as well as Frag. Same story. I am going to put the Protective Collar on, because honestly, the minus 5% damage is very negligible, especially when he does have the Ancestor's Candle. So, it should be a fairly straightforward fight, and with Mathis being here, Mathis is going to be able to take down pretty much all of the adds that we find inside of the estate. So, especially against the Necromancer Lord. So, two keys will bring a couple of extra herbs, and yeah, here we go. The final Necromancer Lord, take it away, Uncle Wayne.
I brought my colleagues back with much of their intellect intact. A remarkable triumph for even the most experienced necromancer. Freed from the trappings of their humanity, they plied their terrible trade anew, the dead reviving the dead, on and on down the years. Forever.
Forever.
A devil walks these halls. Only the mad or the desperate go in search of him. A handsome reward for a task well performed.
Forever, Uncle Wayne says. All right. We've got business to attend to here.
Foul invention.
So Mathis's goal here is just to basically curb stomp every single ad that we get from the Necromancer Lord. I'm very interested to see what kind of mobs are going to be seeing on the way there. I've got to say, from playing so much of the Dark Souls board game now, I am looking forward to seeing what the Darkest Dungeon board game will be, if that ends up coming to fruition, which I have heard that it will be. I have heard, anyway. I hope, anyway. We have a Sergeant, Cultist, Champion, Bone Royalty, and a Cultist Witch. They got surprised. It's very unfortunate for them, but yeah, we're just going to start teeing off. Bone Royalty, not going to get a bleed, of course. Takedown. Not to worry about the stress coming from that. Jenna can get a little bit of damage there on the Cultist Witch.
As the light gains purchase, spirits are lifted.
Mathis with 23 and 10 non-crit.
Clear.
Now, of course, the only drawback to not having a Man-at-Arms is that we're not going to be able to guard effectively, but it's okay because we do have two Houndmasters that can guard. Houndmasters can also give us the AoE stress heal, which you saw in the other episode from the other day. Name's taking a lot of damage right now. He is marked, so we do have to be a little bit cautious on that. Good job, Frag. Way to go. Good hit. This is the bleed, which is actually surprising. Pull on Davis is going to crit. And also move Davis somehow? Not quite sure how they managed to do that. Unfortunately, we have to heal. I say unfortunately because, well, I would like to have attacked, but Davis, we're going to go ahead and move him back. Still going to go for Davis, so we might have to put a guard on him just to protect him. Mathis, 40 damage total with the hue.
A faint hope blossoms.
All right, so we're going to guard Davis with Frag. We're going to go straight for Frag. Can easily dodge that because Frag has a whole lot of dodge right now. 72 dodge because of the guard. We're going to go ahead and purge here. This gets the witch right up in the position that we want her to be in. Davis going to use a little bit of stress healing here. Very nice roll, actually. Very, very good. And we'll go for AoE heal with Jenna. Only a 5. A little bit sad face on that. I think, again, we probably don't need to use the guard here. I'm just going to have Davis sort of self-medicate his stress a little bit. Gonna heal again. Nice heal by Jenna. 7s all around. We expected her to go before anyone else. Nice dodge there by Davis. Lucky dodge. 33 non-crit by Mathis. No problem at all.
This expedition at least promises success.
Digit scouting. It's gonna be a shovel vent. 2 curios. Might as well see what's in here. Not a whole lot. We got a little bit of food. We'll give that to Davis. Here you go, Davis. Chow down with your non-chow chow. Out of all the dog breeds, chows
seems bent on preventing
chows
passage.
Are one of the few dog breeds I don't think I would ever own willingly or ever. Nothing against chows or chow owners. I just they have a certain demeanor about them that I don't really quite mesh with too well. Chows are sort of scary, man. I've never been afraid of any dog that I've ever met, but chows, I've seen them do some pretty crazy things. I'm just gonna stop this line of thinking now before I offend all three of the chow owners out there. If you don't know what a chow is, by the way, it's the big, bushy, hairy lion dog that you see every now and then. They have the characteristic light, black tongue.
The promise of safety.
The only dog that I know of that has a black tongue. I'm gonna push Jenna, and they did get the push. Pretty good. Yeah, I'll take down the witch. Obviously, the ghoul here is gonna be for Mathis. I'm gonna go for the rend on Mathis. 15 damage. Yeah, so she will die to the bleed, and Mathis, 23. I probably could have buffed him up a little bit. And we're just gonna use the AoE heal here. It's not that important that we're not getting that extra healing in this fight anyway, but it would have been nice. Alright, let's throw up a... Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna be a little bit greedy here. I'll be greedy to get one roll off of stress. We know that the witch is going to die. Soul toss on Jenna. 13 damage. Not that big of a deal. Stun is a little bit of annoyance, but... yeah. 11 damage from Davis. Not bad. I'll take it. Mathis is going to unload here on the ghoul. 21 damage. And we will go for a guard dog on Jenna. There's the howl. Craig predictably would dodge that because he has so much dodge right now. I'm actually going to be greedy here and move Davis back. And I'm also going to buff Mathis up to see if we can get a crit here. The reason why this is greedy is because I obviously could have killed the ghoul here, but I want to make sure that we get a heal on Jenna. There we go.
Prodigious size alone does not.
I wasn't looking to heal stress there. I just wanted to get a little bit of HP healed on Jenna. That's why I was a little bit greedy. I could have ended that fight. Anytime you can end a fight in Darkest Dungeon, but don't.
A blazing star is born.
Just because of whatever reason, that's, in my opinion, considered greedy. Here we go. We got a Brigand Hunter, Brigand Raider, and Infamous Blood Letter. 21 crit by Frag. Quakes. Nicely done. Did not get the bleed. 68 bleed versus 139, huh, game? Sure thing, game. 26 Davis. Man, both Houndmasters teeing off. Mathis still has the buff from the previous fight. 70 crit by Mathis! A 70 crit! That's the highest damage. That's the highest hit I have seen in Darkest Dungeon.
The bigger the beast, the greater
the
glory.
Good lord, Mathis games. 3 crits in that entire fight, in that entire first round. That is insane. Need to get Mathis a little bit of help here. Pick up with the shank on Davis. Good resist. He is marked now, though. Not a great heal by Jenna. Gonna purge. Why not go for the kill? Well, for one thing, Mathis couldn't hit him, and for two, we need to get a heal on Mathis. So we're gonna guard dog with frag. And they're gonna go for Jenna instead. Swing and a miss. Gonna be greedy here with the stress heal because I know Jenna's gonna go before Mathis. There's the big heal that we were waiting for from Jenna. And Mathis, 19, not enough to kill. Unfortunate. I don't want to give him another chance to get a bleed.
Give them no quarter.
Apparently, I did not buy bandages. I thought I did. I don't want to get rid of our food quite yet. Okay, we got 100 light. Yeah, we can get rid of some gold. Not a lot of gold, but... Alright, I think we should put a heal on Mathis instead of... Probably don't need purge anymore. We need heal and we need chop. Even though I'm not using chop very much, I am going to use it against the necromancer, though. I want to keep revenge. But I think for Mathis, we're going to give him Solemnity. I can't even say it now. Solemnity. Whatever, Solemnity is what I'm going to say. We did get the surprise here, so we want to take down the Bone Bearer immediately. As fast as possible. Because it is buffing right now the other monsters group. 15 damage by Davis, very nice. Jenna, reduce the dodge. There we go.
The way is lit. The path is clear.
We require Mathis with a 34-19. The crit's gonna remove one of the corpses, so defend the icon. Game gets a counter crit. No surprise there. Holy rally. Gonna resurrect the other skeleton, which who cares about that really? All right, so we're gonna give a dodge buff to Mathis for one. Davis is gonna go after the Bone Bearer. One off lethal count it, by the way. And the icon again. Gonna heal. Mathis is going to heal himself as well. Frag again with 72 dodge. We are not worried about Frag.
Continually on.
Frag gets the dunk.
Destroy them all.
I'm going to use this time to get greedy here because it's a Bone Militia. Who really cares about the damage of a Bone Militia? Now that Mathis has a self-heal, he can also take care of himself a little bit as well. And also increases his resistance to, I think it's all resistance, actually. Yeah, it's everything but stun resist. So this is a nice fight for us to gain a little bit of respite here. Some free stress heal, some free healing on Mathis. There we go. Beautiful job. Mathis almost topped back off. Gravel's gonna go after Jenna. Oh no, 5 damage. I think we'll be okay, Mathis. One off lethal counted.
Their formation is broken. Maintain the offensive.
Nicely done, team. I like it. Looking good. Looking sprite. Looking springy. I don't know what that means.
Packs laden with loot are often low on supplies.
For the anti-venom. I thought maybe we'll fight some spiders or something.
In Radiance, may we find
the Necromancer
victory.
Lord should be here. We're not going to get scouting, so I'm going to assume that the Necromancer Lord is in here. But first, we're going to go down this hallway to make sure. Getting greedy with this urn here. The only reason why I did this is because Mathis can increase his buff by himself. So we're going to get rid of rests, shovels. Oh. A little bit of a waste there, but oh well. And Mathis stepping on trap. Good job, Mathis.
Curious is the trapmaker's art.
Back we go.
His efficacy unwitnessed by his own eyes.
Now it is entirely possible that the boss is not down here. And that would be unfortunate. Well, I was really hoping we would get a scouting proc, but what can you do? Alright, so we're gonna camp.
A spark without kindling is a goal without hope.
So Mathis is just going to get super buff. Go. And we'll go for a Hound's Watch. Go for a Therapy Dog if we wanted to. I think Sanctuary would be better on Mathis. And then with 2 Respite left. Go and Encourage on Davis. He could use some encouragement. I could have used Wound Care on Mathis as well, but then. Alright, I'm going to assume that the Necromancer Lord is in here. Don't make assumptions in Darkest Dungeon, but I'm gonna anyway. And there he is.
Fierce, terrible, nightmare-made material.
34 crit. Now I know what you're thinking. Invicta, how come you're not going to mark the Necromancer Lord? Well, we're not going to need it. Alright, so there's the ad for Mathis. If we want Mathis to go buck wild on the Necromancer right now, we could. I forgot to use the dog treat on Davis. My bad, Davis. Definitely want to debuff him. Across his damage and accuracy, Mathis is going to get buffed up. Getting pumped. Necromancer Lord knows what's going on. If he doesn't, he's about to. Nice bleed there by Frag. 6 feet under. Another stress attack and another summon. 2 shield walls is a little bit annoying. Again, I forgot to eat the dog treat. Mathis, 16 and 12. Not the best hit by Mathis, unfortunately. Swing and a miss. Gonna lower his dodge to zero. And again, this is why you take Houndmasters. They're just going ham on the boss. Use the dog treat. Use the dog treat. Use the dog treat. You gotta use the dog treat. Three shield walls is ridiculous. I've gotta say a game. Dog treat. Davis with 20. Necromancer Lord, 46 HP left. Yeah, this is why shield walls are ridiculous here. With three of them. Get on Mathis, who cares? Not Mathis, that's for sure. Mathis. 13 and 12 hit. Well, the good news is that the Necromancer Lord can't summon anymore. Drag 17 damage. Again, you see here that what I was saying is that we really truly do not need the mark. So he is just all kinds of dead. There we go.
With no living sinew to actuate them, will these walking bones finally fail?
Nice heal there by Jenna. Now we get to take our sweet time to reduce all of our stress. Mathis gets to go absolutely buck wild on these two, well, three shield walls. What off Lethal Counted, by the way. Alright. Good fight, team. I wasn't even worried. Nice heal there by Frag. Press heal, that was. And we're just gonna get some more stress relief going. I'm gonna buff Mathis up to Oblivion. He's gonna go back to Breaker of World status. That's gonna keep going right after Mathis. You're just gonna make him mad, I'm telling you. You don't wanna make Mathis mad. Mad Mathis. This would be a great parody video. These two shield walls are like, dude, we can't kill this guy. We got this leper, we got this gold man right in our face. And these dogs are just howling away, but we can't kill him. What do we do? Oh god, we lost our boss. I'll try to knock him back and stun him and unbelievably pass that roll because Mathis has a freaking... whatever. Oh yeah, he does lose the stun resist, I forgot. Whatever. Down you go. I'll probably do one more roll. One more rollover. Again, they're going after Mathis. And again, you're just going to make him mad. There we go. All the stress has been taken away. 38 crit. Oh, Mathis. Unstoppable. What an absolute beast Mathis is.
So clearly in view. Or is it merely a trick of the light?
11,000 gold. Mathis ended up getting wasting sickness. Fengophobia's got to get taken care of, so. But there you go. The necromancers are completely done now.
Finally, the serum is working. And the side effects are manageable.
Here we go. So we'll take that out there. We'll get that for Davis. I don't think Frag had anything. I don't think Jenna had anything. There you go. All right, everyone. I'm going to wrap it up there. We're coming close to the end as another boss falls here as we take a look for the next episode, which may or may not be tomorrow. We'll have to wait and find out. We've got ourselves... what do we have here? We got... Ancestor's Code, so good for dodging. And another Guardian Shield. Another Blasphemous Vial. Recovery Charm's not terrible. And another Wounding Helmet. So, yeah, we'll probably just go for the... Gibbering Prophet, I guess. Hell's Hairpin there. I don't really like the pistol. Not really needed. Another Quick Draw Charm would actually be pretty cool. So it looks like we're gonna go, yeah, let's go for this Cove run. We'll go grab another Quick Draw Charm. So again, I do appreciate the support of everybody here in the season 2 of Darkest Dungeon as we prepare for the Crimson Court DLC. It's coming to a close very soon because the DLC releases in about 2 weeks. From now. So thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, kindly let me know by hitting the like button, dropping a comment, subscribing if you want to see more, and as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!